Hello students, in this video I'll be discussing about the vector identities and its derivation. The first one, curl of grad phi, this is equal to 0. In fact, we have already derived this in an earlier video. We will repeat this. Now grad phi by definition is dou phi by dou x into I cap. This is the first term. The remaining terms can be obtained by cyclic change of x, y, z, I, j and k. So we will use the summation symbol to represent each of these quantities. Now curl of f, this is summation. The first term is dou f3 by dou y minus dou f2 by dou z I cap. Now if we replace f with grad phi, then f2 is dou phi by dou y, f3 is dou phi by dou z. Therefore, curl of grad phi, this will be summation dou by dou y into dou phi by dou z minus dou by dou z into dou phi by dou y into I cap. So this will be summation dou squared phi by dou y dou z minus dou squared phi by dou z dou y into I cap. Now from the calculus of more than one variable, we know that these two partial derivatives are always equal. Therefore, this will give us summation 0 I cap. Therefore, curl of grad phi will be a 0 vector. Now again, we have grad f to be summation dou f by dou x I cap. Now divergence of vector f, this is dou f1 by dou x. That is, vector f is f1 I cap plus f2 j cap plus f3 k cap, which is f1 I cap. Now f equal to grad f implies f1 is dou f by dou x. So divergence of grad f will be summation dou by dou x of dou f by dou x, which is summation dou squared f by dou x squared. Now if we expand this summation, it is expansion by cyclic change. Therefore, this will be x changes to y and y changes to z. Now if we remember, del squared is dou squared by dou x squared, dou squared by dou y squared plus dou squared by dou z squared. This is the Laplacian operator. So divergence of grad f will be del squared f. The next identity we have is divergence of curl f is 0. Now curl f by definition will be summation dou f3 by dou y minus dou f2 by dou z I cap. So divergence of f is summation dou f1 by dou x. Now f vector f is curl f implies f1 is dou f3 by dou y minus dou f2 by dou z. So divergence of curl f is equal to summation dou by dou x of dou f3 by dou y minus dou f2 by dou z. Simplifying this, we get dou squared f3 by dou x dou y minus dou squared f2 by dou x dou z. Now here these are two different partial derivatives, so they do not get cancelled out. Instead, to prove the result, we have to expand the summation. So we have dou squared f3 by dou x dou y minus dou squared f2 by dou x dou z. This would be the first term plus. In the next term, we have dou squared f3 becomes f1. Now the cyclic changes x, y, z, f1, f2, f3. So after f3 we should have f1, x becomes y, y becomes z, then dou squared f2, f2 becomes f3, x becomes y, z becomes x. And finally, dou squared f1 becomes f2, y becomes z, z becomes x, minus dou squared f1 by y becomes z, x becomes y. Now if you observe, we have for this, we have corresponding term here. For this, the corresponding term is here, and for this, we have the last term here. Each of these pairs cancel out because of opposite signs, and therefore, the result is a numeral zero. Note that divergence is divergence of a vector is a scalar, so this is a scalar 0. Unlike the first case where we get curl of gradient, which is a vector 0. We have curl A, which is summation dou A3 by dou Y minus dou A2 by dou Z I cap. If we have to take curl again, we need to know what are the components of I, J and K. So this will be dou A3 by dou Y minus dou A2 by dou Z I cap plus dou A1 by dou Z minus dou A3 by dou X J cap plus dou A2 by dou X minus dou A1 by dou Y K cap. Now we need to take curl of curl again. That means we should have A3 and A2 into I cap. Now here I should have coefficient of I in curl F or curl A. This should be coefficient of, sorry, this should be A3. So A3 is coefficient of K cap in curl A, and A2 will be coefficient of J in curl A. So that will be dou A2 by dou X minus dou A1 by dou Y will fill the first bracket. The second bracket will be filled by dou A1 by dou Z minus dou A3 by dou X. Now we rearrange the terms, that is dou squared A2 by dou X dou Y minus dou squared A1 by dou Y squared minus dou squared A1 by dou Z squared plus dou squared A3 by dou X dou Z into I cap. Now we can bring the like terms together or similar looking terms together. So we have dou squared A2 by dou X dou Y minus a plus dou squared A3 by dou X dou Z minus dou squared A1 by dou Y squared minus dou squared A1 by dou Z squared I cap. Now if you observe the first term, it is dou by dou X of dou A2 by dou Y. The second term is dou squared A3 dou by dou X of dou A3 by dou Z. So to complete the pattern in this, here the missing term is dou by dou X of dou A1 by dou X, and here the missing term is dou squared A1 by dou X squared. So we add and subtract, the missing term, that is dou squared A1 by dou x square. Now this will result in, so we have, this is the term that we added and subtracted inside the summation. Now in the first three terms, dou by dou x is a common, so we have dou a1 by dou x plus dou a2 by dou y plus dou a3 by dou z minus, we can take common, and we have dou squared by dou x squared plus dou squared by dou y squared plus dou squared by dou z squared a1 I cap. Now we can split this as, now dou by dou x of, now inside the bracket, if we recollect the definition of divergence, this is del dot a cap or divergence of a cap, a vector a, minus, now this is a scalar operator, which is that is the Laplacian operator, which is del squared. So we have del squared a1 I cap, that is summation dou by dou x of divergence of vector a into I cap minus summation del squared a1 I cap. Now by definition, now divergence of a is a scalar. Say phi. So the first term would be, by definition, gradient of divergence A minus, here del squared is a scalar. So if we expand the summation, we get del squared a1 I cap plus del squared a2 j cap plus del squared a3 k cap. So we have gradient of divergence of vector a minus del squared of vector a.